Welcome back. As Namibia prepares for the presidential and national assembly elections next week, November 27th, the media's role in ensuring transparency and fairness is more critical than ever. The recent elections media report released by the Media Ombudsman, Dr. John Akuta, and his team sheds light on important findings from the ongoing media monitoring project. Now, this initiative evaluates media coverage to promote unbiased reporting, also combat disinformation, and empower citizens to make informed decisions come election day. Dr. Nakuta joins us this evening to elaborate. Good evening and welcome.
Good evening, Nina.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you very much, and thanks for the invitation and opportunity.
This is the fourth report,
yes,
that we've had. So I want to dive right into some of the key findings for the October elections media report.
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. Basically, this fourth report doesn't really differ that much from the first three, the three that we've already released. But at least with this one, we see very established trends. Mm-hmm. For example, one trend is that, of course, the first report we've seen that the SWAPO, the ruling party coverage, mm-hmm, was quite, the difference between the ruling party and other small parties were very, very much high.
Mm-hmm.
So much so that it almost caused controversy in terms of our findings. But what we see now is that the gap between the coverage that the various political parties are getting, including the ruling party, is really, really very marginal. Mm-hmm. Of course, the SWAPO party, as a ruling party, still receives the majority coverage. But in the last report, we have built in what we call indexes,
mm-hmm,
matrices, and you spoke to Christy.
Christian.
Yeah,
mm-hmm,
and he explained those. And with that, we can make a determination as to say whether a bigger reporting on SWAPO, bigger coverage on the ruling party necessarily amounts to bias.
Mm.
And the matrices and the indexes that we've built into says not necessarily,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
because we've built into what we call volume to size. And what we found is that yes, and you've mentioned it also this morning, yes, of course, the ruling party is much bigger.
Right.
It's also having a much more prominent role in our body politics. But if you compare the size and the number of reportings related to SWAPO, then you actually see the data shows that the reporting on SWAPO as a ruling party is really, really much lower than it's supposed to be.
Mm.
And the converse is true for the smaller parties. In fact, smaller parties, compared to their size and the reporting and the coverage that they are getting, as a percentage, they actually get much more comparatively than the ruling party SWAPO.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So also, and again, what we found is that once again, there's no specific political parties curated stories, mm-hmm, selling, mm-hmm, their candidates and whatever.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we are asking, for example, I'm sure you've also seen, we have seen the IPC candidate on South Africa television,
mm-hmm,
both SABC and News Africa, selling himself,
mm-hmm,
as a candidate for, mm-hmm, the Namibian elections. And this report basically is trying to ask the question, why don't we see those kind of initiatives,
right,
for the local media?
Mm-hmm.
Because after,
mm-hmm,
all, you are trying to sell yourself to the Namibian public that must vote for you.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you do such a thing? And this report is saying, unfortunately, political parties are not proactively creating,
mm-hmm,
and curating those kind of stories to sell their parties,
yes,
and whatever. And I was this morning asking, could this probably be linked to our electoral system? Because remember, in the National Assembly, we don't vote for individuals. We vote for political parties.
Mm-hmm.
And it might just be that political parties don't see the need,
mm-hmm,
to sell their candidates,
mm-hmm,
that are going to the National Assembly.
Mm-hmm.
It is enough to sell the political party,
mm-hmm,
and however many number of seats we are getting, we will get in there. Mm. Whether it's a John or a Nina, it doesn't matter, because it is determined by our list. And so that probably asks for, in my opinion, and that is not what the report is saying, that's probably one of the things that we will have to seriously engage as a post-electoral, post-mortem kind of thing. Is it about time that we change our electoral system in order to maybe get people directly from a ward system and whatever to be going to the National Assembly?
Does the report make any recommendations for improving media coverage during the election period?
At the moment, to be very honest, we are just collecting the data. We are not yet at the recommendation level. Because this, as I said, is our second last report. Our last report would come out after the elections. And with that, we will now then combine all these five reports, and only then, objectively viewed, the idea would then be to make action-driven recommendations for policy reforms and stuff. So basically, I've now jumped the gun, basically.
I wanted to ask, will your your focus be shifting with the last report that comes out after the elections?
What do you mean in terms of shifting?
What will you be looking at in generally?
No, because remember, the mandate of the Media Ombudsman is to look at media content. So it will not necessarily shift in terms of, but what we've done is, like, for example, we did not cover for this report and even the previous report issues on women, because there was nothing substantively reported on women. Even though the data is there, but we did not include it in our report. Similarly, also on social media, what the researchers are telling us is that it is so insignificant that you cannot really make out anything. So basically what, and I like what Christy is doing, from month to month, what is the data telling us? What is significant to report on? For example, in this month's report, we are reporting on the ECN, for example, because there was a lot of volume in the papers regarding the ECN. We know about the controversy, about the tendering of the ballot papers. So in the August, is it August? No, no, in the September-October report, it was necessary to report on that. So we will see what are those things that we are not reporting on, or that we ought, that we want to report on, but generally is what the media has been reporting on in terms of content.
What has the feedback been from, you know, journalists, media houses in terms of these reports?
It's a very good question. When we walked in here, I asked your producer, can I say this? And she said, say that. what we hear and what we pick up, it's like everyone appreciate this initiative. Because remember, this is the first of its kind for Namibia. It's never been done, and of course it's the first one, and of course we've made mistakes. We are not perfect, but everyone is saying this is a very good project, and I'll dare say, the kind of reporting that we see, because really, what Christy also mentioned this morning, we cannot genuinely say that the media is biased towards any of the political parties. The media is really doing a good job in trying to stick to the yardstick of remaining neutral to all political parties and candidates, and there I must pat the media on the back. And I'm asking myself, and some of us are saying, it's probably because they are now aware that you are being watched. And as I said right in our very first interview, if you can remember, this is not a policing exercise, but it's also at the same time an opportunity to introspect. What are we doing? What have we been doing? Can we improve? And this process and this project basically, in my opinion, provides the media houses an opportunity to reflect. And I think what we see in the data is saying that almost all political parties, even the smallest one, are getting the kind of coverage that they deserve compared to their size.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Dr. Nakutsa, always lovely having you with us. We look forward to the final report after the elections. So we'll be engaging you soon.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so
much. And thanks for the opportunity granted.
We'll be right back with some more conversation after this brief break. Stay with us.